also have Major Muhammad Ali Shah who's joining us. Thank you so much, sir, for taking the time out. If I can just quickly start by, taking your first comments on the fact that the Taliban now wants a place in at the UNGA. I mean, at least five of its representatives are on the UN sanctions list. I mean, from Baradar to Akhundzada, everybody is on the sanctions list, and now here they are demanding a place at the UNGA, a seat at the table. Your first thoughts on this, sir?
Firstly, I think they are being unreasonable and they are being religious because already they defied the UN. They have already put forward a challenge by showing them that we do not really care. We might have whether Brother or Akhundzada or Sirajuddin Haqqani or anybody. You can put anybody on as a global terrorist and we'll get him over as a cabinet minister. And now they are saying we want a seat in the UN. Well, they certainly are being unreasonable. In a country where women are allowed to beg, but they are not allowed to work or to get educated for that matter. In a country which talks violence, they only talk about guns, bullets, firearms. A country which only talks violence and non-peaceful methods. A country which has a different interpretation of Sharia law than Iran or Saudi Arabia. A country, so I feel they are being totally unreasonable and let's see, I mean, I think it's unfair, frankly speaking, it's also unfair. Because if it's something like, if an employee in a company defies a boss, that, oh, I will not obey your orders, let's see what you can do, and then ask the boss for a raise, it's as good as that, or ask for an appraisal. So I think it's they're being very, very unreasonable on this, and I am really, though I had expected it, I knew the Taliban will ultimately come forward and they'll try their stunts, they try working up their way, but it's unreasonable as well.
Right.